first time I went to see him was for a job interview. He was the world's best-selling author. He was a wild man. He was had this notorious reputation. And I drove my car up this 1 mile driveway to this beautiful home. And someone met me outside and they took me up this winding staircase. They opened the doors to what I thought would be an office, and it was a bedroom. Harold is sitting in the middle of a king-size bed, has a cigarette in his hand, his signature black sunglasses, and he looks at me and he says, "Hi, I'm Harold Robbins." When I first went to work for Harold, we would spend like 2 hours every morning together having coffee, talking about what we were going to do during the day. And he was telling me all these stories, and I'm just overwhelmed. There's always a germ of truth in what Harold says. He may enhance it. He's a great storyteller, and he can make the smallest story become international. Harold always said, you know, if you want to know me, read my books. I write about the world around me. So the wild things he either experienced or saw. He was a wild man. There was no rules with Harold. He would say things that were provocative. He would do things that were provocative to see how you reacted. He loved sex. He was the man who invented sex. He started talking about it when nobody else talked about it in literature, because I worked as his editor, along with being his lover for 15 years. And we were married for 5 of those. I wrote this book to give a clarity to Harold's image. So much of the publicity is Harold Robbins writes about sex, power, and drugs. He did more than just write books and become the best-selling author. He changed the way that publishing was done. When he came out with his book, The Carpetbaggers, which is the book that probably made him most famous, he insisted that they publish both hardcover and softcover, and so more people could be exposed to literature. Well, my book is Harold's story. It's his life, in his words. He had wanted this book to be written, and he wanted it to be written by someone who knew him. Harold and I always had fun, and that's what made this man incredible, was that he could make everything fun, even the worst of times. I think that remembering all those little moments was the most fun.